Well, as everybody knows, this time of the year, we normally fish out in Lake Bourne, out in the Rigolets area. Well, since the spillway, all the trout has moved out and they're coming back, and they've been pretty good sized fish. But we get here early, got some good quality shrimp, and we're gonna head out and we're gonna fish the L&N train bridge this morning. We're gonna get after it in the dark. Early no bird. Lights, early bird gets the worm. Yeah, they all was beautiful lately till today. Can't get rid of these suckers.
The redfish. Did they bite you up? Did they like this?
No. And they all overs. Just overs.
All overs?
Catch one every now and then. You got a gun or a trout?
This place is cursed.
You got a trout?
This place is cursed with fish right here.
You think? Why do you say it's cursed with fish?
Because I've been getting a bite every time. My first throw like on every time.
That's an under. That's an under.
I have a fish bumping. But
you got a fish bumping?
I got a little. You got one.
The right flavor. The right flavor of the month. We've been looking for these. This morning, guys, we went out to the L&N train bridge and didn't work out. We had a lot of rain yesterday, had about 8 hours of rain, had a lot of fresh water. So we come on and moved back up here to the 90 bridge, got in between some pilings, and actually we're in the shade right now. This is the guys we found. Big male trout. We're gonna see if we can get you a couple more. Got a little line rise, that's good. That's a head shaker.
Not too bad. I want a bigger one though.
I want a catfish shaker. There he is. That quality. I hooked him that time. Pound closer, buddy. What you think?
Not impressive.
This is not impressive to a man that's been catching all big fish all day. Well, we know they got one on here, but yeah, we're just gonna do a drive-by. That's what we're looking for. Right next to the crab trap, you got a big old triple tail. And you see how close we got? That didn't bother him. So he just went down a little bit. We're just gonna loop around. We're gonna get set up and put a little live shrimp on. We're gonna come back around, do the same thing, but we're gonna feed him with a hook and catch him. And he's sitting there nice and pretty on the crab trap.
Uh-oh.
Well, you want to get the fish or a crab trap?
Reverse. He's out. Yep. Just work him on in. We get him on in there. And there's a nice little triple tail.
Man.
There he is. Nice, beautiful little triple tail. Good eating stuff. There he is.
Coming after you, you got him. I'll be
dead. You had him on.
I had him on a string. It was just a matter of him eating it. Keep the line off the boat. There you go. Throw you the white one, like Casper. That's a lot of work for that, huh? Well, Chris, fishing these triple tail ain't even been as easy as it used to be. You actually got to work for them. We're seeing them. They're actually a little down. They're deeper than normal, and but they're still out here. So I mean, like I said, some of them are a little tougher to catch, and pretty fish. So now we got five people out here. We have to figure out who's going to eat this one.